We're going to talk about chelonians, and which are divided into turtles and tortoises. Turtles can be soft-shell turtles, hard-shell turtles. Hard-shell turtles are commonly called as terrapins. But we're going to talk right now about star tortoises. These are commonly housed tortoises in Indian zoos. You find them quite a bit around. The way to identify this tortoise is, of course, this hard shell that they have and these stumpy feet, almost like elephants. You see that they will not have any flippers when they're walking. They're very comfortable on the ground. They don't have any flippers, so they can't swim very well. But they do like to go into the water and have a soak occasionally, so that they can thermoregulate. They drop their body temperatures. In chelonians, that is all species mainly of freshwater turtles and tortoises, the female is larger than the male. The other way to identify the difference between males and females is by looking at the plastron. So in turtles and tortoises or chelonians, the shell is known as the carapace, and the bottom or the abdominal part is called the plastron. So here you will see that in this animal, the plastron has a concavity. So you will notice that it is curved like this, and that's a male. In addition, the tail of the male is longer. So this is a male. Whereas females, as you will see, are much larger and the abdominal part or the plastron is flatter. It's not curved at all. So this is how you will tell males and females. These star tortoises, you know, it's quite obvious why their name is given like this, because of this beautiful star pattern that they have. But as you can see here, depending on where the tortoise is, the distribution in India is, you will see that there is also a speckled pattern. So the patterns are not necessarily constant across the board, but in Indian star tortoises, so there's also a Burmese star tortoise. In Indian star tortoises, you will notice that the lines, these yellow lines, don't always meet. So it's like a flare of yellow that is there on the shell, but they don't always meet. But in Burmese star tortoises, there's exact union between these yellow lines. So this is how you can tell the difference between the species. And it's important to know this because there's a lot of trade with star tortoises going on. So we need to know what species we're getting, where it's coming from, so on and so forth. So now we know that this is a female and this is a male. We are here in an enclosure that houses a large number of star tortoises. And star tortoises are originally arid species. They come from areas that are dry. So you have to be able to provide for them in an enclosure with stuff that they would need. So like you can see here, there's a star tortoise that goes in the water. Now tortoises, we looked at their legs and they don't have the ability to swim, but they certainly enjoy a good soak and a drink of water. So they will go inside, they will have a drink of water, they will thermoregulate, and they use this. This is a good time for activity. It's also a good time to see what they're doing, how they're moving, whether they're going to be able to eat or not. It's a good enrichment activity for them as well. So as you can see, they enjoy a good soak. They hydrate themselves with that, though they don't necessarily swim. They certainly like to hydrate, and they're very, very comfortable walking on uneven surfaces of land, and they like hiding in the shade. I just wanted to quickly show the parts of the tortoise. See, the feet of the tortoise are stumpy, almost elephantine. And that's why they're so comfortable on land and unfortunately not very comfortable in water. They have no webbing between their toes, so they can't swim very well. If you can see here, just behind the ear, it's a ring, a yellow color ring right here. And that is known as the tympanum. They don't have external ears or pinna like we do, but they certainly have a eardrum. So this is almost similar to the eardrum that we have. So they hear very well. and therefore whenever you're dealing with these animals you need to understand what their senses are like. And at the tip you will see the nostrils, and these are the eyes. When you're examining the animal or when you're looking at the animal to identify whether there is something wrong, these are the things that you need to take care of, to check if the nails are okay, if the feet are okay, if there's no injuries there, if the eyes are clean and bright, no discharges, if the nostril is clean and there's no discharge from the nostril, and the eardrum is intact without any discharges. This helps to identify whether the animal is in good shape, if there is anything wrong with it, or and if any intervention is needed.